हेलो गाइस, हेयर वी प्रोवाइड यू ऑडियो डिक्टेशन इन ओरिजिनल वॉइस ऑफ डॉक्टर जी डी विस्ट एट अ स्पीड ऑफ 100 बर्ड पर मिनट. इफ़ यू वांट मोर दीज टाइप डिक्टेशंस एट अ डिफरेंट स्पीड ऑफ ऑल बुक्स हिंदी और इंग्लिश देन सब्सक्राइब लाइक शेयर और कमेंट्स ऑल्सो ऑन माई चैनल. And lot of thanks of any kind of suggestion. Now ready?
Exercise 13. The girl had expressed a marked reluctance to stay with her father. The High Court was of the opinion that the children had developed long-standing affection towards their maternal grandfather, aunt and uncles. It will take a while before they develop the same towards their stepmother. The sex of the minor girl who would soon face the difficulties of attaining adolescence is an important consideration, though not a conclusive one. She will benefit from the guidance of her maternal aunt if custody is given to the respondent, which the appellant will be in no position to provide. Further, there is a special bonding between the children, and it is desirable that they stay together with their maternal grandfather, uncles, and aunt. In case of custody of the minor children, the family law, that is, the Mohammedan law, would apply in place of the act. Considering the provisions under section 353 of the Mohammedan law, the High Court had held that the preferential rights regarding the custody of the minor children rests with the maternal grandparents. After making a doubtful proposition that in case of a conflict between personal law and welfare of the children, the former shall prevail, the High Court held that in the case at hand there is no such conflict. For the reasons aforementioned, the High Court, by its impugned order, set aside the order of the Family Court, Bangalore, which vacated the interim injunction issued against the appellant. It is this order of the High Court which is challenged before us by way of special leave petition, which on grant of leave has been heard by us in the presence of the learned counsel appearing on behalf of the parties. It was the contention of the appellant before us that the act will apply to the present case because there is a conflict between the preferential guardian in Mohammedan law and the act. It was pointed out that while deciding the custody of the minor children, the welfare of the children had to be taken into consideration and that it was guaranteed by the Act. They have placed their reliance on a case of Rajasthan. The Rajasthan High Court in the cited case held that where the provisions of personal law are in conflict with the provisions of Guardians and Wards Act, the latter shall prevail over the former.